A week ago, I wanted to charge up my lead acid battery with my lab bench power supply. So I set its voltage to 14.4 volts and its current limit to 1.35 amps, just like the label of the battery recommends it. But apparently I had too much to drink, and as you can see connected minus to plus and plus to minus, which resulted in a small spark at the minus terminal and the fact that my power supply is now constantly shorted, even when there's no load connected to it. In a nutshell, that means I cannot use it to power anything, which on the other hand means it is busted. So in this video, let's find out how we can repair such a damage and also how we can create a circuit that can protect our devices from such a reverse voltage. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by JLC PCB, where you can order custom PCBs with ease. Their digital manufacturing technology ensures high quality and accuracy for a price of only $2 for 10 PCBs, with 48 hours quick turnaround. For the first repair step, I obviously had to open up the lab bench power supply. After removing a few dozens of screws, I removed the nuts that hold the main PCB in place and lifted it out in order to inspect the circuitry around the two power output channels. What stood out to me was an SMD diode, which was connected between each one of the output terminals, like it's shown in this schematic. That means that when the battery load is hooked up properly to the output terminals, the diode does practically not influence the current and voltage values. But if we connect a reverse voltage to the terminals, then the diode shorts the power source and protects the inner electronics from the harmful reverse voltage and current. The only problem is that the diode will most likely not survive such a current surge, which was true for my case as well, since I could measure the forward voltage of the diode at the still functional channel, while the defect channel delivered way too low voltage values. So to fix my supply, I simply had to desolder the blown up diodes, order some new ones of the same type, and solder one of them in place. And after reassembling the lab bench power supply and powering it, it seems to function correctly once again. Awesome! But the question remains whether this kind of reverse voltage protection is the best option, which, let me spoil the surprise here, it is not. First off, you would usually add a fuse in series to the plus terminal, so that if there's a reverse voltage, it would get blown and thus interrupt the current flow instead of constantly shorting the battery load, which could end with terrible results. And the next problem is that a reverse current flow through the inner electronics is still possible, which in my case was apparently not a problem. But take for example Electroboom's inverter, which got completely busted by reverse voltage and also featured the same protection circuit. So what we need to do is to completely stop the current flow through the inner electronics, which can be achieved by simply putting a diode in series with the output terminals. If the battery is connected properly, current flows through it, and if a reverse voltage is applied, the diode blocks the reverse current. Sounds like a perfect solution. Well, unfortunately, it is not that perfect. We can find that out by measuring the temperature of the diode while in use, which turns out to be at around 47 degrees Celsius with a current flow of 2 amps. The problem is that this Schottky diode, which already features a small forward voltage, still creates a power loss of approximately 0.84 watts at 2 amps in the form of heat. And let's not forget that the voltage at the load is not stable due to the variable voltage drop of the diode according to the current flow. So what is the best reverse voltage protection, you might ask? Well, through our earlier circuits, we know by now that we need some sort of switch with a very low resistance that turns on if the voltage is applied correctly and turns off if it is connected the wrong way. So the solution is a P-channel MOSFET, like this IRF5305, and a well-known schematic like this, which you can find all over the internet. As a first example, let's use a light bulb as a load, instead of the battery, to keep things simple. If the power source is connected properly, and I'm using a voltage of, for example, 12 volts, then we got a voltage potential of 10.7 volts at the source, because there is an initial voltage drop across the MOSFET's body diode of around 1.3 volts. And since the gate is connected to ground, so 0 volts, we got a gate to source voltage of minus 10.7 volts, which according to the MOSFET's output characteristics graph, turns it on. In this state, the MOSFET can reach a resistance of 0.06 ohms, which at a current draw of theoretical 2 amps, would equal a power loss of 0.24 watts, much better than the diode. Of course, we still have the problem that the voltage drop varies with different current draws, but the effect is much less noticeable with the MOSFET. Now, when the voltage is applied the wrong way, we would get a theoretical gate-to-source voltage of plus 12 volts, but the MOSFET only turns on with voltages lower than minus 2 volts, which means it will stay off. Sounds like an awesome protection circuit, but you have to keep in mind that with a lower power supply voltage, the MOSFET's resistance increases and thus its voltage drop, which makes it horrible, inefficient and useless at low voltages. Also, my MOSFET's got a maximum gate-to-source voltage of plus minus 20 volts. Anything above that will lead to the destruction of it. But of course, you could add a resistor and a Zener diode in order to limit the gate voltage to a suitable limit. Now, since we know all the important facts about this reverse voltage protection circuit, it is time to replace these simple resistive loads with our battery. As you can see, by applying the voltage the correct way, the battery charges like usual. But if we connect the battery the wrong way, the fuse I added for safety reasons keeps popping, which means there's still a problem. The reason is that the battery adds its own voltage levels to the circuit, so that the MOSFET is not closed when the reverse voltage occurs. Hence, this circuit cannot be used for voltage sources. Only loads. Thankfully though, while tinkering up a solution circuit, I found Vincent's Thoughts block, which offered a very minimalistic solution to the problem. His circuit basically ties the gate voltage to source with a resistor, in order to keep the MOSFET normally off. And only if the battery load is connected the right way, it powers an NPN transistor, which pulls the MOSFET's gate to ground and thus turns it on. After building up the circuit and connecting it to the battery, I can confirm that this circuit is not only very simple, but also functional, so feel free to try it out yourself. Of course, there also exist versions of the MOSFET circuits with N-channel MOSFETs, instead of P-channel types, if you're more into that. And with that being said, you're now familiar with different reverse voltage protection techniques that will hopefully help you to not destroy your lab bench power supply like I did. If you enjoyed this video, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!